So this finding the largest number, I will share the PPT. So where we have a flow chart for better understanding. So here it shows a simple flow chart for finding the largest number. Okay. The flow chart tells you that. So before that, you must know what is the input, what is the output. So how many location you are going to compare. So for example, I'm going to take five locations. Okay, I'm going to take five locations. In my five locations, I'm going to place my data. So I'm going to place my data in random way. That is 2, 4, 1, 5, and 3. Okay, this is already, this is my input. This is my input. So as per my program, as per my algorithm, that I want to find out my largest number in this array. So my largest number is 05. So after my algorithm finds out this 05 in any one of the location, I want to push this to any one of the output. So if you consider port 1 as the output, you can push it there, or you can push to some other register, okay, resultant register. So anything you can do. Okay, this is my output. This is going to be my output. Okay. So for this, I'm going to write the logic. How I can write the logic? See, so if you take any program, we will initially start the program by giving an instruction ORG 00H, which indicates that your program is going to load in this 00H location. Okay. Start. And then you are probably, you will be stopping your program by giving an instruction called end. Simple instruction. So before that, you can use, sometimes end will not work. So that's why we are placing this small jump. Here, short jump. Short jump here. Same instruction will be executed in a loop so that the control will be here. It will never move to here. Right? So if you in exam, okay, whatever may be, you try to mention these three instructions. Okay. So all the program will have initialization process. That is, we have to initialize. Since it is a memory related program, so I want to point to particular memory location at the initial stage. Okay. I want to point to this memory location so that I can have a memory pointer by having instruction. Simply, you just take one of the register like R0, comma, you place this 30H. Okay, always use hash 30H. Now the data 30 is moved to R0 register. Hereafter, this R0 is going to be your memory pointer. Okay, this is going to be your memory pointer. Okay. Okay, fine. How to find out the largest number? Here your logic starts, because for comparing two data, I'm going to compare these two data. With this, I'm going to find out which is my largest number, which is your largest number. 4, right? So 4 is my largest number. So that this 4, I want to move to the highest address. As per the program is concerned, you can develop your own program, no problem. Here, the next is, I'll be comparing this 4 with 01. And then whichever, while comparing which data is highest, for example, 4, I'll be pushing to higher address. I'm while comparing these two locations. Okay. So next, I have moved here. The process stopped here. So once again, I'll be comparing these two locations. These two locations, what is the highest data? 04 and 05. So highest data will be pushed to higher location. Okay. this way we are going to do the operation. Similar way, I'm going to compare this 5 with 3, which is highest. I am going to place in the, so while I'm going to compare these two, highest I'm going to place in the highest address. Okay, this everything we are going to take the data from internal memory and comparing, and we are going to place it there itself. Okay, this is how the comparison we have to do. For this, we are going to use one instruction, compare instruction. The compare instruction, we are going to keep in loop for 4 times to identify which is my largest number. 4 times, this is one comparison. So this is one comparison, 2, 3, 4. So my counter is going to be 4. My counter is going to be, I'll use some register and I will mention my counter is 4 now. My counter is going to be 4. So you can use any one of the register as per the program. One second. So you can use it R2, okay, which would be one of the. So this is going to be some register where I will be placing 0. That is your resultant register where your result is going to be stored. Okay, fine. Now here, which is your loop process starts. Okay, here it is going to be your loop. Okay, so 4 times we are going to compare. That is initially we will get the number. So initially we point here 30H. So we get the number from the next location. Okay, from 30H we have one data and 31H we have another data that we both are comparing. If both are, while comparing 2 and 4, the second data we received is greater than maximum number. That is maximum number is first data we are taking. That is, we are comparing first data, let us take 0, 2. That is your maximum data, first we received. Whether we are getting a second data which is greater than 0, 2. Yes. So move the maximum number at the maximum location. So since it is already maximum location, the condition is we'll be going to increment. Okay, we'll be incrementing memory pointer, right? So now, since here these two locations we are going to compare next time, we are decrementing the counter. Coming back to the loop, now we are going to get the data. The iteration, that is count value, will be decremented. So count, that is R2 register will be like 0, 3 now. First comparison completed. Second time, you are going to do 4. That is here, it is going to be 1 is greater than 4 now. I will change this. Second time, we are going to have 1 is greater than 4. This is your maximum value, the maximum location. We are getting a data, second data. We are going to compare. No, it is not. It is not greater. Right? So probably, I should do what is my operation. I want to swap it. So this will be swapped. So that we will see in the program. Then we will increment memory pointer, decrement the counter. Then the once again loop will be started. Okay. So let us see how this, for better understanding, I will go with another slide, which will understand a little bit clearly. Okay. See, here you can see, this is for largest numbers. What I told, first we are taking 2 number. Okay. So this 2 number is compared. Highest value we are putting in the highest memory address. Okay. So next is, we are comparing these two. So we'll be comparing these two. And we will putting highest number in the highest address. Next, we'll be comparing the highest number, that is next location, with the highest data in the this highest location. Finally, while comparing these two, higher higher data will be put in the higher address. Finally, the we'll be comparing with last location with the resultant data, and then final data is put into the final. From here, we'll be pushing to some other register or port 1 or port 0. Okay. So during each and every operation, the counter is decremented. So this is the operation the program does. So for that only, I have placed a simple tabulation for your better understanding. The same operation. Here the smallest value is pushed. Okay. Smallest value is pushed while comparing each and every data. Okay. Same operation. Now we will move on to the program. See, I will share the program. I will explain here also. See, here there is a program. Yeah. So this is up to this part is just starting. Here, this is your initialization. Okay. This is your initialization. This is your start, starting at the starting location. And this is going to be your end. And so this is going to be your result loading in the corresponding port. And so this is where your loop program. Okay. This is your loop program. That is, you are going to execute the compare instruction for 4 times. Okay. Simple. Before starting the program, I'll say just initializing. Okay. We are taking a 2 data from the corresponding 2 address, 30H and 31H. We are putting into A register and B register. We are comparing this A and B. Comparing is nothing but doing A minus B. So that is A minus B. We will come to know whether carry is accord or not. From the carry, you can easily check whether the number is highest number or smallest number. Okay. If it is highest value minus lowest value, carry is 0. Lowest value minus highest value, carry is 1. Okay. By this, we can check the condition and whether you want to do exchange or not. Okay. If there is a carry. Okay. No, that is no exchange. The condition, we can move to another memory pointer and you can increment the memory pointer, decrement the count and move to the iteration, starting of loop. Okay. Simple operation. Let me explain one by one. See here, I'll copy this. Open the software. So this is the your just starting a program. Okay. So here we are going to initialize your program. So I'm going to initialize my memory pointer that is R0 is going to be R0 is going to be 30H now, okay, as of now. So just we are placing some the memory address which you want to point, that we are moving to register. Okay, this is going to be your count, how many count to do your operation, 4 count. Okay, this is about the initialization. Here my loop is going to start. So now you can see this. I'm going to move the first two location data into A and B register. Now A is going to have what is my first data. For example, you may have, for I will load the data here also. We can, so you can have a 30H, so you can have a data 02. So in 31H, you can have the data 04. 32H, you can have a data 01. 33H, so you can have a data 5. 34, you can have a data 3. So this, like this, we are giving in random. Okay. So this data, so in, you can see in 30H, what is the data that is moved to accumulator now? Okay, that is 02. And B register, the data, what is the data is 04. Okay. See, this is the main instruction, that is we are going to compare, that is A minus B. Whether carry is occurred, anybody can say what happens to carry? Carry is 0 or 1. Compare A minus B, which is nothing but A minus B. Compare A comma B is nothing but, see, compare A comma B. That is A minus B. Operation is A minus B. What happens to carry? Carry is 0 or 1. 2 minus 4. What happens? Carry. Lowest value minus highest value. Carry is 1. So if carry, no exchange, because see, already in this location, R0 and R1 location, I have 2 and 4. So because in high location, I have high data. That is 404. Okay. See, in here, at highest address, I am having highest value. So no need to exchange. Go to exchange label. Increment R0 and R1. Okay. Decrement the counter. Decrement counter. Now counter is going to be R3. First operation completed and we have the same data at the same location. Fine. So since we have incremented R0, R0 will be 31H and R1 is going to be 32H. Now I'm going to compare these two locations. Okay. See, the iteration will move after decrement. It will move here and it will start. So now, for the second iteration, what is the value will be moved here? Accumulator will be having a data at R0. This is going to be R0 now. That is, it is going to be 04. And it will receive the second data. That is, it is going to be 1 now. Whether the carry is 0 or 1. A minus B. See here. 4 minus 1. highest value minus lowest value, carry is zero. Check. Jump if carry. There is no carry. I want to exchange. Here, I want to do exchange because I want to put the 04 in this highest location. So I'm going to exchange here. Now it is going to exchange after this operation. That is, A is going to be 0. What is after exchange? A is having 4. Now it is going to be 1. And B is going to have 4. Now you can push A and B in the corresponding location. So now at 32H, it is going to be 4 now. Okay. So as per this thing, now 32H will be having 04. Highest value is moved here. Okay. Here 31H 01 is moved. Okay. So then we'll be incrementing this. So after incrementing, so here after incrementing, R0 will be 32 and R1 will be 33. So now we are going to push here. Now we are going to compare these two. Here, these two address. So in this 32H, we have 04 now. Okay. So like this, it is going to compare that for decrementing 2 now. So like that, automatically decremented like this. Okay. Finally, if it is 00, it will move out. So the result will be in R0. Since we have lastly incremented at R0, that is 34H, you will be having a maximum value. That is the result value will be moved to port 0. Okay. So this is the operation. Let us execute. We'll compile this program. There is a syntax error. Check the syntax error. Here it is N, should be N. And okay. So we have a zero error. You can build the program. Okay. So as per the program, I'm using internal memory. Internal memory at the address of, right? So internal memory. So internal I colon 0x30h. This is my address where I want to give my input data. I want to 2, 4, 1, 5, 3. This is the data, which is the input to my program, which is input to my program. This is input to my program. From here, the program will find out this is my highest value. This is my highest value. Okay. Let us see how it is going to find out. I'll run the program. Okay. So you can open this peripheral input output port, port 0. Okay. See, in port 0, you can see as per the program, the data output data is moved to port 0. So in port 0, you can see the highest value is 05. Okay. So from this input data, the 5 is moved to port 0. Okay, this is for finding the highest value. The same program, you can use it for finding the smallest number. Here only the difference is you have to put JNC. Okay, JNC. That's it for smallest number, finding the smallest number. Compile the program, build the program, then finally go to debug mode. So in the debug mode, give the input data in the memory location. The same data you can give 1, 5, 3. Okay. So I'm giving five data, and I'm going to the same pore. I'm going to find out which is my lowest number. So we have a five data here. From here, we are going to find out which is my lowest number, and we will compile. After compiling, we will debug. We'll run the program here. So you can see in the same port pin, the data is 01. Okay. The data is 01. So after we can able to find out which is the smallest number.